Hello, this video was created to explain how Storage DRS initial placement works and to prove that Storage DRS is not responsible for virtual machine provisioning but only for initial placement recommendations. I have two vSphere web client sessions to my vSphere environment. One is from Chrome and second one is from Firefox. So, you can see here a data store which has 2.78 gigabyte free space. Let's create a virtual machine to data store cluster. Let's choose a VM name test from Chrome. We select ESX02 where data store cluster test is connected. We know we have 2.78 gigabyte free on data store 1, so we will configure 2 gigabyte hard disk for a new virtual machine. Now you can see Storage DRS recommendation for appropriate data store. It is data store 1 because we know that there are no other data stores with free space. Let's hold this provisioning process for a while and start another one from web client session in Firefox browser. Let's start the same provisioning request. The only difference will be in the virtual machine name. Let's choose a virtual machine name, test from Firefox. Now we can see that Storage DRS recommends us also a data store 1 because there is still free space as a first virtual machine provisioning process has not finished yet. Obviously, there are no other Storage DRS recommendations. Let's finish the provisioning process. You can see that it has been completed successfully and you can see a virtual machine test from Firefox deployed on data store 1. Now let's move back to Chrome web client session and finish the first VM provisioning process. You can see the process has failed because in insufficient space. This is a proof that Storage DRS is not responsible for provisioning and it is just a placement engine giving recommendations for whatever vSphere client communicating with vSphere through vSphere API. The client can be web client, old C# client, Power CLI, vRealize Orchestrator, vRealize Automation, vCloud Director, you name it. Thank you for watching.